Hey, Tom here, Flip Anything USA. So on my blog, I share how I made my fortune in real estate, starting at 19 years old, millionaire by 28, and I did it just one small deal at a time. So look, I'm about to show you a video where I made $1 million. And I shot this video a couple years ago before I even had a book, which here's my book, Wake Up and Smell the Real Estate. Doing very well. It's on Kindle. And Kindle's the way to get it. Get the book on Kindle if you want to get a book like this. You can click right to the links. I have links to videos. I've been making videos for 3 years, just now finally starting to get noticed. But I really have made millions and millions of dollars on real estate transactions as an investor. And I've done things that I've never seen anybody else do. In fact, wait until you see this next video. Please like and hit subscribe. Hit subscribe right now so you don't forget. And if you don't like, you can always unsubscribe. But enjoy. Really watch this one. This is a really good one. Tom here, Flip Anything USA. It's funny, I'm driving around looking at real estate and I realized there's another way I've made money that I should share with you. Several years back, I was negotiating the purchase of this building that you see behind me. We made a deal. I was buying it for $1.7 million. And what happened was there was problems with this property in as much as there were some issues in the ground. In fact, I'll show you what I'm talking about. There was issues with this property in regard to the company that was in here, is my understanding, you see these tanks behind me? That's where they test the ground material that they get out of the ground table here. But what happened was, is this property had a tenant in here that processed circuit boards, and my understanding is that some of their waste would process out and go into the ground. And for whatever reason, I guess it wasn't good for, you know, there was a concern. And you can see behind me, these are test digs where they have like these little wells that they come back and sample to see if the ground is contaminated, or if it was contaminated, if it's improving. And so what happened was, First Bank says, hey, we can't finance that thing, it's got these issues, it's like a super fund possibility, meaning there's a problem, like, you know, they don't want to loan me money on a property that could be taken away or be considered so contaminated that it's not worth what I paid for it. And so that became an issue. Then I went to another bank and they said, hey, same thing, we can't finance this thing. And so I had to go back to the seller, because we both want to make a deal. And I said, look, man, I've had two or three banks say, no, can't do it. And I said, next bank, that if I do go to a bank that says okay, I think I'm going to say no, because the other three have got me so concerned. He took that in consideration, and I went on and I actually bought two more buildings. And then he came back and said, hey, look, this is going to be cleared up in, you know, 6 to 18 months. He goes, what if I make you a hell of a deal and I lease it to you real cheap until we get to where we can close it on a sale? And I said, hey, that'll work for me. What do you got in mind? He proposed me such a low rate. I mean, this is a very big building. This is like 26,000 square feet. And so we made a deal, and I leased it for $3,000 a month. Well, that 18 months ended up turning into about 7 years. But keep in mind, this building would have cost me about $20,000 a month to rent. Or, you know, the bottom line is, I made the margin between $3,000 and $20,000, or roughly, or maybe it's $3,000 and $15,000 or $3,000 and $25,000. I mean, it's worth even $25,000 a month now. Eventually, we kept the thing going until he raised me up to $5,000. And I'm telling you, that wouldn't even pay the taxes on this building, okay? That's how great a deal this was. But the bottom line is, just to say I made $20,000 a month times 7 years, that's, what, 84 months? Making $20,000 a month. So I made over $1 million roughly by not even owning it, because by leasing it for $3,000, it put me in a position, I had the right to sublet. So I re-rented the building to another company, at a rate of $20,000 to $25,000 a month over that period of time. So I was making $14,000 to $20,000 a month on this thing for all these years. Well, eventually it got to a point where he was getting tired because he's not able to pull this thing out of the deal. And now I'm telling him, hey, I'll just go ahead and give you $1.7 million cash. Well, now the building's worth about $4 million. And so he doesn't want to sell it to me for $1.7 million. And, you know, which is okay, because I've already made so much money on the property as a tenant renting it. And I like the guy. He's kind of a gruff guy, actually a pretty rough guy. But he's an honest guy, and you know what? We've had a great relationship. I've taken good care of the building, but I had a great rate. I was able to make a lot of money on the deal. And so I wasn't gonna press him to sell it to me. I'm not built that way. I probably could have made him do it, but I'm not gonna go do that. But the point is think about what a great opportunity that is. If you can make a deal, sometimes, I mean, see again, this wasn't even by design. He came to me and said, look, I'll just rent it to you cheap till we get this thing worked out. And then it just never worked out. But in the meantime, I think it was 7 years I rented this thing, and I rented it, and then I re-rented it to somebody else. You know, I just made a lot of money. And you know, we're talking, you know, a couple hundred thousand a year. You know what? There's a lot of different ways to make money. Just keep your mind open and the ideas will come, because so many of the, like, you know, the owner financing came to me, the bird dogging and being paid a finder's fee, that all just came kind of just by me getting out there doing things, and the situation just kind of dictated it, you know. That's what happened on this one. It wasn't by design. I was looking for places to lease and do that. But I understand that people doing Airbnb, what they will do is they'll take a rental and they'll rent something long term for say $3,000-$4,000 a month down at the beach. Then what they do is they turn around and they rent it for $2,000 a week to somebody else. And maybe they only rent it 3 weeks out of the month, they still get $6,000 and they're only paying $3,000. You know, there's a lot of creative ways. I've never done that, so I can't really tell you how to do that, but I can tell you what I have done in regard to leasing and releasing, or leasing and subletting. Hey, just something for you to think about. Always here to share my experiences making money in real estate. And get out there, keep bird dogging, and keep your mind open about how you can do things, because you know, there is no set way. You can pave a whole new path that nobody else has ever thought of. So, and don't think you can't. You know, you can create anything with a contract. You can make any agreement you want that somebody else will agree with. You can do anything.
So that's how I made over $1 million re-renting a property. We call it subletting. Anyways, that was one hell of a deal. And you know what? Anybody could have done it. I've done a lot of deals. I've done things that I've never seen anybody else do. But I know that all these things can be done by anybody. I'm not special. I keep my eyes open, and I'm not afraid to ask. Okay? So get my book. $10 on Kindle. Take care.